What's up, Street Talk? So we are here in the park with my buddy Elmar. You know him as East Block Boy, right?
Yes.
He's the always
the beast from the east.
The beast. Yeah, he's Karlsruhe.
Karlsruhe. Yeah.
You probably never heard of Karlsruhe, but that's okay. Come to Hamburg, but not to Karlsruhe.
Yes.
So he is Mr. Gear Acquisition. How many cameras do you own right now?
Right now, it's a Contax T2, mm-hmm. Leica M6.
See Leica, you in half an hour.
Leica CL, yeah. Nikon Z6, and some other stuff.
Okay, that's it?
Nikon 35 Ti.
Okay, the better question is, what are you about to buy in the next weeks?
I'm satisfied right okay. now. I'm really, really satisfied.
Yeah, yeah, so we are here to do a little comparison because he got the Leica CL. And as you know, I have the Minolta CLE, and they have a kind of a relationship. They have history together because Leica made the CLE, I think, together with Minolta.
Yes.
Minolta helped them with the electronics.
Yes.
And after the CL, I think Minolta made the CLE, and then I think Leica saw the CLE, and the CLE sold a little bit better because of aperture priority and all the good stuff. That they canceled the partnership. I think that's the story I read online. So yeah, let's see what's different. This is the cheapest Leica you can get.
Yes, absolute cheapest.
How much did you pay for this one?
I paid 150 euros for it. Only for the body.
Oh, okay, 150?
Yes.
Yeah, usually when you go to eBay, you find the CL and the 40. There's a Leica Summicron, right? For like 300 or 400 euro, so you're basically getting the lens and the camera for free.
Yeah, camera for free. But most of the times the light meter does not work. That's what the seller says. I found out that most of the times it's a user problem.
Mm-hmm.
So the light meter most of the times works for me when I buy like a CL. Mm-hmm. Yes.
How does it meter? Is it always on?
No, it's not always on. You have to kind of put it in this position to get it on.
Okay.
And then you will see inside a little marking that's going up and down for the exposure. And if that does not work, here's the battery test button. I don't know if you see it right here.
This one?
Yeah, this one.
Yeah, okay.
And you can press it some times in and out. And after that, you can check it again if it will work or not.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's a contact problem between this button and this
And lever. Do you need a battery to use the meter?
Yes, you need a...
what? I didn't know it opens like that.
You need a...
is the camera okay?
The camera is okay, yeah. It's a little bit Frankenstein, but it's okay. You need a Macri cell. 1.35 volts. It's not out there anymore. You can buy a replacement wind cell, it's called. It's a zinc oxygen battery, but it lasts only 6 weeks.
It's probably hard to get it at a store. You have to probably order it online.
Yeah.
Because I have two batteries that you can still buy at, you know, Rossmann or Butni.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is maybe one downside for the CL that the battery is hard to get.
But lucky me, I have one in it. And it lasts for years.
Yeah, yeah.
The Macri cell.
So this is also how you put the film in the camera.
Mm.
Yeah, maybe we can do that later. Oh my god, it looks so scary. let's compare maybe the size. I think, let me take off my... I have this leather case, half case. And without it, I actually don't like how it feels. It's too small. But I think they're pretty similar in size, right?
Yes.
Look very similar. Yeah. And of course, one big difference is here, of course, the shutter dial. Yours is on the front, and you can exit it like this, right? Yeah.
I can. Yeah. Quick access is when you look through the viewfinder, you can check your metering and you can change your...
Yeah, I will try to include the viewfinder. I will record it on my phone maybe. Yeah, on mine it's a simple dial here, that we are used to. The problem is it's a little bit, it locks here, no? For aperture priority, mm-hmm. and then I can have to press this here for exposure compensation. Then if, when I'm out, I can change the exposure normally, but it feels a little bit cheap. Mm-hmm. I like this a little bit more, how it feels, because this feels a little bit plasticky, but aperture priority. Do you have aperture priority?
No, it's fully manual.
Yeah, that's super like convenient having aperture priority, but I have to admit, because I have aperture priority, I don't shoot manual that much. What I've noticed is looking through your CL, it's a little bit smaller, the viewfinder. It's not bad, but definitely have a little bit more room in my viewfinder.
Yeah, I like it also way better than this viewfinder.
What if you have a 28 on right now?
Yes.
So this is the Minolta Rokor 28, right? And look at his front element.
Oh.
This is a common problem on this lens. It's like a coating defect.
Yeah,
or
called Schneideritis.
Yeah, Schneideritis. Because of... warum Schneideritis?
I don't know.
Yeah, and I have... Let me show you mine. I got very lucky because when I bought the CLE, it came with the 28. And it's a little bit dirty right now, but there are not these white spots. I think almost all of these lenses, when you find them online, they have these white spots.
Yeah, almost all.
But you can clean them, right?
Yeah,
you What is can. The place in Germany? Maybe someone wants to know. Where you can clean it?
It's a guy that does it at his home.
Okay. But where can people
you
find
can
them?
Search for it on and find the link on Flickr for the repair guy.
Yeah, what's
search
his name?
Like, oh, I don't know. I can Google it.
Okay, we will include it here. You have to send me a link so that I can put it here. Yeah, usually you can buy the CL and the CLE with this one, the 40. But this is the Minolta version and there's a Leica version of it. And I think the Leica version doesn't really work that well on the CLE. And the viewfinder frame lines a little bit different. I tested it on with the Leica Summicron, and I don't know what I wanted to say. It's just a little bit different, and so you should use the native lenses. So Minolta on Minolta and Leica on Leica makes the most sense. But you've been shooting the Minolta 28.
Yes.
How do you like it?
It's very good.
Do you have 28mm frame lens?
No, that's
no?
the problem.
Yeah.
I don't have the 28mm frame lens, so most of the time it's guessing what's in the corners, but you can see it and you can always crop the image afterwards a little bit.
So you use the whole viewfinder?
Yes, I use the whole viewfinder.
Mm.
I also have the 35mm.
Yeah.
With me. And,
you use it on this one?
I mostly use the 35 because when you look through it, it's almost a complete viewfinder.
Okay.
And you have the whole world in it, like mm-hmm. when you photograph it.
Uh-huh, I see. Yeah, on mine, this is also the reason why I wanted the CLE, because of the 28 frame lines. And I know now that on most Leica M bodies, you can just use the whole frame or some cameras have the viewfinder, the 28 frame lines.
Yes.
But for people wearing glasses, it's sometimes hard to see, right?
Yes.
So it's not impossible to shoot 28, but on this one it's very nice because you can still see what's outside of the frame. But I can't use a 35, I have to do it, I have to guess and then use the frame lines from 40 and 28 and then guess. But yeah, I like 40.
Yeah.
What is nice.
And also in this CL, the frame lines are fixed, like 50. You can use a 50mm Summicron on it, or the 40, yes. And also there's a 90mm lens for it, and when you put this on, the frame lines will appear. But a standard, there's only 50 and 40mm frame lines.
And it always shows the same frame lines?
Yeah, always shows the same frame lines.
Okay. Yeah, when I change to the 28, I only have the 28 frame lines, but when I switch to the 40, I have 40 and 28.
Okay. That's better.
And do you have a self timer on the CL?
No.
No?
No self timer.
Yeah, I have a self timer here, but I have to switch it up and then take a photo, and it's 10 seconds. I actually really like the self timer because then I can take, you know, a family portrait, a group photo. I don't know what else we can talk about. Do you know a little bit about the CL's history?
It was published with the M5.
Ah, okay.
So, and then they, like I said, they put the CL cannibalized the cells of the M5.
Mm-hmm.
So they discontinued it after 3 or 4 years because the sales were that great and it was very cheap to get.
Yeah.
And they would not sell that much M5 bodies.
Mm.
But at the time also Leica had some problems with camera body selling, so we don't know 100% what's the case that they did not sell this over 10 years or something like this.
Oh, yes. So, and after that one, the M6 came?
No, the M4? Was M5? Oh god.
So confusing.
Cut. yeah, das müssen wir mal gucken.
Ansonsten. We don't know.
We don't know.
Google it. Okay. So why did you get the CL? You have an M6.
Yes, I have the M6.
So why you got the CL?
Sometimes I don't want to bring my M6 to some places, or when it rains outside, or dusty, very dusty environments. And also when I want to carry a very, very light, small body.
Mm.
Yeah, it's compared to the M6, this body is very, very light. And if you put on the 28 like this, or even when you got the 40.
Let me hold it again, I want to see how. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
When you got the 40, it's even smaller. Yeah. Yeah. So you got a real pocketable Leica camera with you all the times.
Yeah.
With super manual functions. Yeah.
How do you set the ASA value?
You need to press it and then turn your finger.
Ah, okay, interesting. Okay, cool. Yeah, I actually know a guy who shoots on the CL. I think he's also like a ambassador. I will link him up here. Shout out to him in case he watches this. He does take amazing photos on the CL. But I don't know many people who use the CL like for serious.
Yeah, it's work. I just watched through your viewfinder and got very, very jealous because it's so much better than this one. Yeah, so
yeah, I mean, it's not the huge difference, or maybe it is.
I also think that the colors are very much better. In
Yeah, it feels a little bit
like the glasses.
We just talked for 10 minutes and the camera shut off, so let's do it again real quick. So, CL and CLE, I think you were talking about the metering. So how does it work?
So, in the CL, there comes out a little arm with a diode on it, and this measures the incoming light through the lens. So it's also a kind of TTL measuring. Mm-hmm. And when the shutter goes off, the arm also goes in.
Mm, okay. Nice. My reaction is like, okay, whatever, I already seen it.
Yes.
But can you film then my CLE? And we do the same. Okay, so this is how it looks like inside the CLE. And this weird pattern is, I think, for the light to what did you say?
To
reflect the light.
Inside.
Inside, yeah. Diodes. It's hard to show, but there's some, I don't know, what's it called?
Diode.
Okay, and this is how it looks like when I take a photo. Wait a minute. Ah, jetzt funktioniert's. Okay. So, another thing I forgot to mention is this shutter button is touch sensitive. So when you touch it, it will show you the exposure, the metering. So it didn't work, so I couldn't take a photo. And that's a downside with this camera. Without a battery, you can't take photos. So here we go. Shutter. Boom. Oh yeah. And that's it. Okay.
Okay, lass wieder umdrehen.
Gut. How do you know how many shots you took? Is there any...
Yes, there's a...
Ah, okay, so it's... Oh yeah, it looks exactly the same. Right?
Also almost, the, yeah. Also, when I look on it, yeah. Like this...
Yours has these spikes. Mm-hmm. Mine's is just flat. And the shutter button is also interesting. Like, it's so far, like, in the middle.
Yeah, but it's super convenient. Oh, for me, okay. I have like
yeah. It always hands, on yeah? photos it looks like it's on a weird position, but for because me, it's small, it's probably not.
It's very good. It has a good grip for me, mm-hmm. like this, and I can change the shutter speed also very quick and take yeah, after that my picture.
That's cool. Okay, hot shoe or cold shoe? Looks like it's a cold shoe.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have two contacts, and I know with the right clash, you have TTL as well. What else can we say? What is this again?
This is the reminder what film you have inside the camera.
Ah, yes. So on other cameras you have this where you can, you know, put in a piece of your film package, and here you have these symbols like a sun and a light bulb and.
Yeah, and black and white,
thing,
but it's not very practical.
Yeah.
But it's practical, but not practical because you don't know what film you put in, but you know at least, okay,
it's black and white, color.
And fast color or slow color.
Okay. I guess let's load a roll of film on the CLD. Yeah?
What else? Did we show the how the ISO is changed?
Yes. Ah, maybe you can show us again.
And maybe we can also say it's like from ISO 25 only to ISO 1600. So it does not go to 3000.
Yeah,
200.
I think mine is also just. Oh, yeah. It also goes to 1600.
1600, but you have exposure compensation on it. So you can. Make up to 6400.
Oh, yeah, maybe. Yeah. I never thought about it. Yeah. I guess you're right. Okay, so I have a film in here, so I don't want to waste it, but can we load a roll
yes,
film?
Yes.
Because it looks very funny on the CL.
When you got shots on it, it's this bit like this.
Mm-hmm.
You open here a little bit. Yes. And put it up, goes to zero, and it opens like this. And I think when...
Looks easy.
Very easy and super practical. When we got it open like this, we can also show how the mechanics are inside.
Mm-hmm.
And this is like bulb mode.
Oh.
Yeah, it's very slow.
Nice.
So, I will put in some Agfa Vista 800.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's best before 2002.
Okay.
But was stored in a fridge.
Yeah.
For most of the times, but to be sure, I will shoot it at ISO 600.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And this film is, I think, discontinued?
Discontinued, yeah. Long. So, have a good look at it.
You will never see it again.
And it's a little bit tricky to put in. And, okay, I think, nope.
This looks definitely more complicated than on the CLE.
Yeah, but maybe it's also a user problem.
Ah, I see, yeah.
Now make it work, I hope.
Was ist das hier? Was fliegt hier rum?
So, when you press it, when you got it in like this, yeah, press it down and see if the holes, the sprocket holes are inside and then... Okay. It looks like it's tight enough, so... Done.
Whew. Easy.
Very easy. So...
Nice. Yeah, okay. That's all we have today. This is a quick comparison between the CL, the Leica CL and the Minolta CLE. Any shoutouts? Where can people find you? Eastblock Boy on Instagram.
And that's it.
That's it?
That's
yeah?
It. Yes.
No other site? No. Okay. Yeah. Let me know if you enjoyed this video, this spontaneous nerding out. And yeah. See you in another video. I don't know how to end this.
Okay, let's bye. Go. Bye bye.
Guck mal, wie viele. Ja, was ist das? Ich hätte mal die Tasche nicht auflassen sollen. Diese ganzen.
Willst du noch ein paar Close-ups drehen?
Ah, ja.